Hi guys, so today I wanted to come on and show you how I do my box for pom-poms. I'm going to demonstrate it with my 4-inch template. So what I do is I kind of look around the house for something circular, and I think this one, which I use for my yarn remains, is the one that I use for my 4-inch. So I went around and used my tape measure, and then found that this one was 4-inch. So I traced it on a piece of cardboard, and that's what I'll be using for my template. The 4-inch I normally use from newborn to toddler, and then I'll use the 6-inch for child to adult. So this is a piece of fox fur, and what I like to do is I like to make sure that the fur is going downwards first, and then I flip it, and I put it at the far corner. So I grab my marker and I trace around it. And this is just a Sharpie. And then I'll take my scissors, and the way that you cut it, let me see if I could get closer. The way that you cut it is you're trying to push your scissor as close to the back end as possible. So you don't want to just go in and cut. You want to, like, sometimes I hold it like this so I could get more traction. And I hold and I kind of push the scissor up here to use the scissor to split it, as if, I don't know if you could tell. Do you see how it's like underneath it? So I push the scissor close to the back end as I can. And now we have our little circle. Okay, so what I was doing before was I was using a yarn needle and pushing it through the edges. Let me just tell you, that's a pain in the butt. So that's what it is. It's the Coates and Clark Outdoor UV Resistant Polyester thread. So what I do is I insert the thread from the back to the front and just fold upwards, fold downwards, fold upwards, fold downwards, and I go all the way around until I'm back at the beginning. Also, you knot the end of your thread in case you didn't know. Like a thick knot, not regular sewn knot, but a thick knot, because we're going to be tugging at this and you don't want it to come loose. When you get all the way around, you fold it like this. Then you take your stuffing, you place your stuffing inside. You don't want to overstuff it, but you don't want to understuff it. Inside, basically gonna just pull on that thread. Pull, pull, pull. And I just like shake it sometimes. Then I go back in with the thread and the needle, and I just make sure that it's sewn up tightly, because just pulling it usually doesn't close it. So I tend to hold the palm like this. Take that, and I'll just just go back and forth through, back through the loop again. Just go crazy, because the last thing I want to do is have this open up on a customer. So I like to say better safe than sorry. So I go back in just a few more times. Okay, so then I'll just cut the end. Put this back here. And there you have it. If you could see all the fibers flying. Yeah, so you need one that's reasonably wide but still have a very sharp edge. Or point, I should say. So I'm gonna get this yarn through there. And I'm going to take it. And I'm just going to push it from one end to the other. Sometimes I have to push it against something else to just get it through there. So as you can see, this is a reasonably easy process if you're just making one to a few palms. But if you're making this to sell and you're sewing a lot, this can be a pain in the caboose. Or I'm just making it difficult, I don't know. I'm probably just making it difficult. Get it in there. Usually take one end. Let's use this hat for example. And I line it up over the area, the closed area. Then I push it maybe, like, say for example, this is the center. I insert it like an inch over from the center. And then I take the other end and I do the same. Tightly. Bow tie. And then I will put the needle back on the end, insert it back up again. Let me just do it. Put the needle back on again. Insert it back up. And find a position on the towards the side, push the needle through there. And then I go back down again. And then I do that to the other side. And then I tie again. The other side. Push it through. And that's how I securely put my palms on both. I do this with the fox fur and with my regular yarn pom-poms. But yeah, so that's how you do it. Pretend that these aren't there. And yeah, so thank you guys so much for watching. Bye.